what we're doing today is we're going to be building another 4x8 worm bed, just like this one over here. As you can see, I don't like to use new materials. I use recycled materials for just about everything we do around here. So today's construction is going to be real simple. I've taken a 4x8 sheet of plywood and I've ripped it into 1-foot strips. I have two of those 1-foot strips right here. I've got two more off in the back somewhere. And then I have 1-foot strips of OSB. Now the OSB rots out really quickly, but this is the second worm bed I'm going to be building with this OSB. So I cut them all into the end caps so that when they rot out, they're easier to replace. So today, it's going to be real simple. We've got our four pieces of ripped sheeting, and we have four 2x4s, or in my case, I have two 2x4s and two 2x6s. As you can see here, I've already started drilling them together. I'm going to put four screws in on this side. I'm going to put four screws in on that side. And then I'm going to screw the end caps to them just like this. And what that does for me is it makes it easy for me to remove the end cap when it comes time to empty out this bin. And this bed won't be emptied out until it reaches the top. This bed I just refilled yesterday. And what I like to do is I start the bottom layer on the very bottom with some cardboard. Then I put in my material that's been screened, that's chocked full of worms and babies and cocoons on top. I put some more cardboard on top, and I give them about a week to get acclimated before I start feeding them some more. So that's a quick little video on my worm beds. I'll take some more video of this worm bed once it's completed, and then I'll take another video once I start filling it back. So I've put this bed together, and as you can see, I dug four holes where the 2x4s and 2x6s are going to be going into the ground, and that's just to secure it so that it stays put. I kind of level it just a little bit since I'm on uneven ground, so not too much. But there it is, and I'll be posting another video tomorrow.
Hey everybody, I'm back. I waited a day longer than I expected to refill this bed, but here I am. I'm going to be refilling this bed. Somebody just gave me a whole bunch of egg cartons. As you can see right here, I got some soaking there. I'm going to line the bottom of this with egg cartons. I usually use cardboard, but I'm going to use egg cartons today because I have them. So we're just going to line the whole bottom. And then once the whole bottom is lined, I'm going to soak it down real good. Once I'm done soaking it down, then I'm going to start adding the materials, and I'm going to be soaking every step of the way. So I'm going to put down the screened material, and then I'm going to soak it, and then I may put down some more cardboard, and then I'm going to soak it. And so now I'm just basically going to just dump these out, spread them around a little bit. Here's some worms. You can see the worms in there. There's one, there's a couple. Yesterday it got pretty warm. I should not have left them in the buckets all night, but I did, and they're okay. They're doing okay. So I'm gonna spread this out. I'm going to spread it all out until I evenly cover the cardboard, and then I'm going to add just a little bit more cardboard and whatnot for them to eat. And then I'm going to let these guys
spread out my 13 buckets of screened worms and food material. And now I'm just spreading out my cartons on top. I'm going to wet it all down here. And I like to get it real nice and wet when I do a new bed like this, so that I can make sure that all my cocoons and my little babies start growing and that my cocoons hatch. If you keep your cocoons real moist, they'll hatch real fast. I've heard that they can hatch in as little as 18 days, but I still stick with typically 27 days, 28 days. About a month. Your cocoons from laid to being born is usually about a month. Under ideal conditions, I've heard 18 to 21 days. So I get it real nice and moist for the babies and for the cocoons. And then I'm gonna leave this bed alone for about a week, and then I'll come back a few days
and feed over the top of it. So for the next few days, I'm just gonna make sure that these egg cartons are moist. I'm gonna moisten them up like I am right now. And then I'm gonna cover them with big pieces of cardboard like I've done over there and over there. So that's how we build a new 4x8 bed out of wood, using nothing but recycled materials, so it didn't cost us anything but the screws. All right, and that's Joe from Amazing Worm Farm. Thank you very much. Have a great day.